Hey guys, what's up and welcome to a new haul video, and this time we have a package from firestartoys.com. And before I open up this package, here is the story behind this. So when I started with Instagram back in the December of 2019 to share my LEGO creations and custom minifigs, I realized that it's a good, quick way to find people that share your interest in LEGO creations. Social media can be a good way to communicate with other fans, and one of these friendly guys was Matt7, who shared the interest in creating custom LEGO Game of Thrones minifigs, and he gave me some tips and also gave me the advice to check out firestar.com to buy some custom minifigure parts, for example. So a really big thank you to Matt7 again, and you should definitely check him out on Instagram. I will put a link in the description down below. If you're interested in funny LEGO minifigure photography, you should definitely check him out. So now I managed to open up the package, and here is what's inside. We have some advertisements for minifigures.com and of course for Firestar Toys. Here you can create yourself and some more other stuff. But before we dive in what I bought, here's a short overview about Firestar Toys, and you can find the homepage when you use the link in the description below. This would be really helpful for me, and I will be really thankful if you use this link. And here is the homepage. You find some minifigs, for example from Star Wars, also from the LEGO CMF series. Also some really cool custom creations, for example this cool Cal Kestis from Jedi Fallen Order. You find some minifig parts like hair pieces, heads, and of course these cool arms, and I bought some of them, you will see very soon. For example, we have the 501st arms, then some helmets and other stuff. Also custom helmets, some capes, some custom printed tiles and bricks, and these pieces are really nice. They also have some for Star Wars, which are one of my favorite pieces. We also have a lot of weapons from LEGO, but also from, for example, Brick Warriors. And even more stuff, but you can check it out by yourself. And now the most interesting stuff, my order. When I was editing the video, I realized that some parts of the recording were missing, so I had to make a new recording, but it's not a direct unboxing from the small bags you can see here, but I show you each piece individually with another background. So the first minifig we have is this one here. This is the Battle Goddess from the LEGO CMF series, and I love this minifig, so I got it for a really good price there. And we got this minifig here, also from the CMF, and these two minifigs were still missing in my collection. Then I ordered some of these new dress pieces here in different and more or less rare colors, and I will use them for custom minifigs. Then I ordered some hats from regular sets. This is from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. This is, I guess, Thor from Marvel Superheroes. And I think this one is from LEGO Harry Potter. And all of these hats are going to be used for custom minifigs as well. Then just this torso here in dark brown for a custom minifig. Then this hair piece here from Qui-Gon Jinn, also for custom minifigs. This cool armor here, which is not officially from LEGO, I think it is from Brick Warriors, also for a custom minifig. This nice greatsword here. And a regular spear. These pieces are a bit wear nowadays as well. This cool little sword here, which is also not an official Lego piece. Then I got this tile here, flat silver tile. And this is Beskar, of course, from The Mandalorian, which is pretty nice. If you have seen The Mandalorian, you probably know what this is. Then this piece here from LEGO Star Wars from Stas Allier. Maybe I'll create another minifig of her species. This helmet here also from Star Wars. I'm not sure where it appeared, but it's useful for another custom minifig. Maybe you guys know which minifig I mean. Then these cool custom helmets here for the Purge Troopers. If you have played Jedi Fallen Order, you know these guys. And I can't wait to build some Purge Troopers in LEGO. Then we got some other custom helmets. This is from Star Wars Rebels, Sabine Wren, I guess from season 3 or 4. This cool helmet here from a clone commander. Absolutely nice. And of course, Captain Rex helmet. And you can attach this piece here on the side. Pretty nice, because it's a really rare piece in the official LEGO universe. Then I have some more Beskar plates. 4 in total. And this is pretty cool as well. This is a custom printed head for Shakti. And it's not the Clone Wars style. I'm going to show you how it looks with the official minifig later. Then some custom printed arms. Here for an Imperial worker. Some more custom printed arms. And this time you probably noticed these arms. Yes, they are for the 501st Legion troopers. Clone Troopers Phase 2, and I guess they will be really popular in the future because the new LEGO 501st Legion set is coming, and the clones included there have white arms instead of blue arms, so it's a good way to upgrade your minifigs. Then we have Sabine Wren with arm printing, so I only ordered the arms, not the minifig itself, and the detail here is excellent. The minifig looks pretty nice, and again, arms for the Mandalorian, which is a cool upgrade to this minifig as well. And another Mandalorian, Boba Fett himself, and he also got custom printed arms with a lot of cool details. Now here you can see another picture of the whole order, and I forgot to show the two capes, the dark red and dark blue one, and the controller piece from the CMF Series 19, which I will use for the Monastery of Spinjitzumok. And here are some photos from Shakti with a new head, and the Clone Wars and the custom head in comparison. And again, all three Mandalorians together. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you are interested in buying some cool custom parts as well, check out the link in the description below. Thank you guys a lot for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Check out my Insta and Matt7's Insta as well. And see you in the next video. Bye!